Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome back. Today I'm going to create a very elegant Mother's Day card. So to start, I am going to combine two products by Simon Says Stamp, this stamp set as well as the dies. This stamp set was designed in such a way to omit the middle letter from the words, and instead you can stamp any of the other designs. Now, in this case, I'm going to use the flowers instead of the letter O. This way I will be able to create a more dimensional looking card. Now I'm going to use my tonic paper trimmer and I'm going to cut out a panel out of white cardstock. And I'm making sure that this is slightly smaller than a standard card, so I will end up by having a nice frame when I stick that panel on top of my card. Now to create a nice background, I decided to look through my stencils from the newest collection by Tim Holtz, and I'm going to use this one because it's looking so elegant. I am going over it with my glimmer paste, and this is Moonstone. It's one of my favorite glimmer pastes. It adds a really sparkle on your projects, but at the same time it locks the glitter, so it doesn't stick all over the place. I have applied it with my spatula, and now I'm going to lift the stencil and let this dry on its own while I will be working on the rest of the elements for my card. Now I'm going to use these flowers, and I'm going to make sure that I separate them. I am actually going to use both of the dies that cut out the leaves, as well as the two dies that cut out the flowers. I will not use the little circle ones for the center of the flowers. So I am going to cover up this white panel with some double-sided tape, and I am making sure that as I stick that tape down, I am not leaving any gaps in between. And I'm going to cut out some smaller pieces of this white cardstock that fit nicely my dies. So I will end up having one of those pieces for each one of my four dies. Just like I did with my background, I want to have glitter on top of all of my focal points, but at the same time I don't want that glitter to go all over the place. So I am going to use this product by Nuvo, which is called Sparkle Dust. This is very fine glitter, and I will be using four colors actually, the red, the pink and the green, and you will see me later on using the dark one. So I am going to cover up, I peeled off the backing from the double-sided tape, and now I'm going to cover up that piece of paper. I'm going to put on top of that some non-stick paper, and I'm going to burnish it with my bone folder. This is going to make sure that all that glimmer dust is nicely stuck on top of my paper, and I hope you can see how beautiful it looks. So I'm going to put that glitter back on the jar, and I am going to repeat the same process on the other piece of paper. So I'm applying my sparkle dust on top of my paper, and now I am going to place the dies on top and run them through my die cutting machine. And you can see the beauty of it, and when you burnish it, it makes sure that all that dust is nicely stuck on top of your paper. But if you run them through your Sizzix machine, this is going to be super pressed down, and you will know for sure that that dust is not going to go anywhere. So I have turned that black piece at the back, and I'm going to stamp the letter M. I want to cut out the letter M twice. And since I didn't have the dies for this stamp set, I'm going to use my scissors. The good thing with the letter M is that I can stamp it at the back, and since it's symmetrical, when I turn it over, I can use the other side, which is the sparkly one. So I'm using my scissors here, I'm making sure that I cut out everything nicely, and this is where I am going to run them through my Big Shot, and notice how I run through the Big Shot machine not only the dies that I wanted to cut out, but also the two letters M, and that's because I want to make sure that that dust is nicely stuck on top of my paper. So I'm going to pop all the images out, And I hope you can see how shiny those are. And they don't stick on my fingers. That glitter doesn't stick anywhere anymore. So now it's time to assemble my card. I'm going to put those on my hands and do a close-up, and I hope you can see how beautiful it looks. Nice and shiny, perfect for a Mother's Day card. And now I'm going to show you the background where I used the glimmer paste. Now, if you can see, just because the stencil is very narrow, the stencil by Tim Holtz, I did have empty spaces on my panel at the right and on the left. So I'm just using my paper trimmer to cut those out. And now it's time to assemble my card. For my flower, I'm going to make a hole at the center of those flowers as I am placing them one on top of the other. And then I'm going to use a brad. Now the brad that I'm going to use has a shape of a heart and a little enamel heart, a white enamel heart at the center. I had these brads for ages. I believe they come from a Hero Arts collection, but years and years back. So I'm going to use my fingers to add just a little bit of dimension on my flower. And this is going to be the O for my word mom. And now it's time to do all the assembling on top of this sparkly panel. And first of all, I'm going to add a foam square at the back of my flower and center it on top of my panel. And then I'm going to stick the letters M. I'm using some Tombow Mono Glue at the back, just because I need to stick that on top of that dry glimmer paste. I needed to use some strong glue to make sure that these letters are going to stick nicely down. So I'm going to place one on each side of my flower, and this is supposed to read Mom. I'm also going to stick the leaves, and again I'm using my Tombow Mono glue to stick those. And notice how I add glue only at the very tip of my leaves, and this is going to make sure that I do have some dimension on the leaves as they pop out. This is a really beautiful and elegant design for a Mother's Day card, and you can find the full list of all the supplies that I'm using today down below in the description area, as well as on my blog. But you can pretty much take the same design and recreate it by using any type of flower that you might have at home, and you can just stamp the letter M with any alphabet stamp or any alphabet stickers. So now for the sentiment, I am using again the same stamp set, and I'm going to stamp with Versamark ink on top of black cardstock one of the sentiments that says Happy Mother's Day. I'm going to apply white embossing powder, heat set it with my heat gun, and now to cut it out I'm going to use a die, which is a very thin strip die that is going to help me out cut out perfectly this sentiment, which is so thin. This comes from my favorite things stamp set. These are the Blueprints 32, but of course you can use your paper trimmer or you can use your scissors to cut out the sentiment. Now I'm going to use my scissors to cut out the big tail at the front. I'm going to place it on top of my card just to eyeball where I want this to go. And I'm going to use some foam squares at the back and secure it on top of my panel. And at this stage my panel is pretty much finished. All I need to do is to stick it on top of my card. But first Ginger wanted to say hello, so he was really interested in looking at that shiny flower, and I just had to give him a good squeeze. And then I will continue with the rest of my card. So anyway, I'm going to stick that panel on top of a standard card that's 4.25 by 5.5, and I'm using some foam tape at the back to add some dimension. And that was the card for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. Here are some close-up photos of the card that I made today. And if you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel already, make sure to do so, because this is the way to tell me that you love my videos and you want to see more. And if you need more inspiration, here are two more cards that I created a while back for Mother's Day. Thank you all for watching.